Hey, it's Laura Jean, and I thought I would leave a little note on suffering and death in light of ALS. I had a minute experience with suffering recently as a pint-sized human being, and a Strider bike barely touched the back of my legs, and I lost my balance. And I got my lovely face, as you can see. I came down on the cement and mostly with my face hit, didn't have hardly any other injuries, and I cried for a couple seconds before I remembered some stuff I learned from Mindful Birthing, a book I read before I gave birth with my third child, that really helped me with pain management, where you actually go into the pain and you don't avoid it. And so I kind of just let myself feel the pain and accept it, and it didn't hurt as much. And I think that's part of my philosophy with dealing with the pain and the difficulties of ALS, being mindful and being in the moment and really living this. What is the point in going into depression over something that you cannot control yourself? If you go into that spiral, that downward spiral, you're basically dead already. You're dying while you're still alive. And you're still alive. Everyone has a date with death. And if you don't really live in these moments, you're wasting your time. So, that meant a lot to me, reading that book, Birth Matters. Mindful Birthing. Yeah, Birth Matters is something else. I've also been thinking about death a fair amount in the last few years. My grandfather passed away in 2013, Opa, and I was really close to him. And the following year, a friend from my church passed away. And just contrasting the legacies was really difficult for me. I loved my grandfather a lot, and he had very strong opinions, and as far as I know, he was an agnostic, a soft agnostic, pretty much to the end, though the Lord knows where his heart is. And my other friend, he believed in God, and he had his flaws and his beauties, and he poured into other people's lives. And just seeing the legacy of someone who's devoted their life to trying to live like Jesus was moving to me and inspirational. So that got me thinking about death. And as I thought about it more, I don't like the idea of death. I guess a lot of people seem that it doesn't really bother them, but I think most people, and me most of the time too, just kind of live in a faint state of denial, where we kind of live like we're never gonna die, and just don't think about the process. But after my opa's death and my friend's death a couple years back, I started thinking about the process of dying. And I decided that the worst death I could die would be one where I couldn't breathe. And of course, that's one of the ways where you can die from in ALS. And some of my other worst fears are not being needed and being superfluous and being insignificant, and those are all things that kind of become part of your life as you have ALS. But are you really superfluous? What is the value of a human life? Is it wrapped up in what we can accomplish? And you already know my thoughts on that. I think the true gem and the true value in a person is inside them. It's their spirit. And And there's always a beauty in that, regardless of the intelligence of the human, or their physical capabilities, or where they happen to be at the moment. Life is precious. And so that's also something I have to wrestle with, because a slow decline is not an easy thing to mentally wrap your mind around. The thought of my body slowly wasting away, and should God choose not to heal me, me having to decide, am I going to remain faithful to Him? Do I really believe what I believe? Or do I not believe it? And I haven't read the book, and pardon me if I mentioned this before, but it's like a long obedience in the same direction. You know, I have to just take it day by day and be obedient in little things in the same way, each little step. And remembering that the sufferings that we do go through, the Bible says that we should know that the same kinds of sufferings are being experienced by my brotherhood around the world. And then after I've suffered a little while, the God of all grace, who has called me to His eternal glory in Christ, will Himself restore, confirm, strengthen, and something else. Me. Gotta work on my Bible memory. It's all over the place. But I'm improving. So I'm not alone in this. My brethren around the world, you know, it's referring to Christians. I'm not the only one suffering. But, you know, I can also interpret that as people with ALS. I am in this with my brothers and sisters around the world experiencing these symptoms of these diseases, or this disease that we do not yet fully comprehend, and taking it day by day. So, here in all the scabs and warts of life, I still stand, and I'll